Hi, I'm in Bangalore today. Today is 29 June 2018 and I'm meeting the NIRAMAI team, and here I have Dr. Geetha Manjunath, who is the CEO and the founder of NIRAMAI Health Analytix, which is working on new ways of doing breast cancer screening. And I'm very lucky and fortunate to collaborate on behalf of Breast Cancer Hub to collaborate with NIRAMAI.
Thank you. Very nice to meet you face to face, Lopa. We've had many conversations on phone, and it's really wonderful to collaborate with the Breast Cancer Hub Foundation. At NIRAMAI, we are coming up with a new way of doing breast cancer screening, which has the ability to detect early stage breast cancer in a completely privacy-aware manner. Privacy is very, very important, especially for women in India who care a lot about the socio-cultural aspects of getting their breast screening done. So what we do is just use a simple thermal imaging device right in front of the like a camera right outside, which measures the temperature variations on the chest. And then we have developed artificial intelligence based computer-aided diagnostic software, which analyzes the heat distribution on the chest to say where is an abnormality that requires attention, right? This abnormality can be precancerous, you know, many years before a lump even is felt by hand, and that's very, very important, because in today's scenario, women don't talk about their breast cancer at all.
Even if they feel anything, also they wouldn't speak up, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. You know, we have found many people who've had like 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters of lumps. They wouldn't have even told their husband or even family members, right? Because they're very scared.
Yeah.
In general, women in India are very less conscious and less kind of aware of their health, and they don't want the family to worry about their health. They don't want to be a trouble to the family, right? So they try to do some natural medication and so on, and they try to hide their problems, right? In the same way, if you go to any hospital, they'll tell you that, you know, women come in with 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters big lump when they are no more able to hide the fact, and by that time it's already stage 3 or stage 4. And so in India, the survival rates are as low as 50%. Just 50%. Every alternate lady who's detected with breast cancer ends up losing her life, right? And if you look at almost like a 5-year survival rate because of late detection, it's much, much lower, almost like 20-25%.
Wow, so like 20% like survival rate, you can say that
in five years.
Which is very, very low.
Very bad. Yeah. And the interesting thing is that breast cancer is completely curable, right? Yeah. If detected early. So at NIRAMAI, we want to bring up a solution which can detect cancer much earlier than lump is formed. So stage 1, if at all, right? You know, if possible. And then do it in a way that nobody is touching her, nobody is seeing her, there is no radiation, and absolutely no pain. So what we do is we keep this device, and there is a curtain. Not even a technician who's operating the sensing device will see the person, see the lady being screened. So it's a no touch, no see, no pain.
That will
solution.
Cover the embarrassment issue too. Like
completely, absolutely no problem. So the embarrassment is a major issue, why people don't come forward, and that's completely covered. And when we do camps, we do that in offices, we do it in apartments, we definitely do it in rural areas as well. There is 100% registration for this, right?
Yeah.
One lady comes in, sees the experience, she goes back, and brings in a lot, many more of our friends for doing it.
Wow.
So we've seen that all the time. We've started camps for one day, we extended to a week, and we've started half a day camp, full day. So this is always over subscription
we've had, amazing.
Right? And it's very nice to see that.
That's great work you're doing. That's really awesome. So do you think, like, you know, what I'm trying to do, like, you know, with coming together, like everyone working together in collaboration, building the network, so that each person then becomes an ambassador to talk about it. Do you think, like, I know it's like a drop of water in the ocean, but do you think that this will help? Like, I just want to understand, because, like, you know, from your perspective, the way I'm trying to build it, will this help with the survival rate eventually?
Absolutely.
What do you think?
Breast cancer is a huge problem. It's a huge global problem where 500,000 women are dying. It's not a single organization which can solve this problem. You need a group of organizations who are like-minded, who are trying to solve this, to come together. That way, Dr. Lopa, you're making a very, very big contribution to the society by linking all of these people together. And then leverage each other's knowledge. For example, you have a wonderful self-awareness brochure that you've made, right?
Yeah.
We would like to distribute that, right? Self-examination,
different languages. And we want to distribute it free. So do you think that will help, right?
That's a very nice thing. Okay. So we will be very glad to give this to all our women who are undergoing the screening.
Awesome.
Because
yeah.
it's not just one time thing, right? You know, they need to know what they have to do every month, every 2 months.
Yeah.
Look for lumps, look for any abnormality in the breast and so on. And it's also yet another organ of the body.
Right.
And the beautiful thing is breast cancer is completely curable,
yes,
right? And
yes.
so we need to take care of our organs very, very early and make sure that, we save our families from the trauma as well.
Amazing. Thank you, Dr.
Thank
that
you so much.
Amazing talking to you. And really, I'm so happy that we are together in this.
Yeah, thank you so much, Lopa. Wonderful.
Thank you.